Hey everybody, I'm Lance Goyke. Today we're going to discuss a particular type of aerobic activity that, you know, is kind of like the first thing that you need to get familiar with and get understanding. And what we might abbreviate this is kind of a hot topic these days, I suppose. It's LSD, okay? So it's not the drug. It is long, slow duration activities. So I'm doing something not too intense. I'm not trying to push myself terribly hard the entire time, because if I did, I would gas out. The activity has to be long, so I have to pace myself to make sure my body will continue working throughout the entire activity. Best example of this is a marathon, right? So let's say I run it in 2 hours because I'm a freak athlete. And the start of a marathon doesn't look like the start of a 100-meter race, because if it did, all those people would get so freaking tired that they wouldn't continue. They wouldn't be able to keep going. They wouldn't be able to keep producing that energy, because their muscles would have to recover from all the byproducts that were being made from those quick, short, anaerobic energy systems. So we're going to start developing our aerobic system in training by doing long, slow duration activities. We're gonna take LSD. This is getting out of hand, Lance. We're gonna take this LSD mindset and we're gonna say, hey, can you tolerate moving for 5 minutes in a row? Like, even for 2 minutes in a row is a really good start. And then for 5 minutes in a row, and then for 10 minutes, 15 minutes, 20 minutes. All you have to start to learn is, how do I pace myself? And you have to teach specifically your muscles and cardiovascular system how to continue to provide opportunity substrates for energy production, and how to take away all the byproducts that are made by some of the, you know, the more toxic energy systems, these anaerobic systems, where I top out, I gas out, I can't keep going. What I need to do is recycle those products so that I can keep the energy flowing. And LSD activities could be, you know, they could look like anything, right? So I've talked about marathons and running. That's the easiest example, but for me, for example, I hate running. I have hip pain all the time, and it's worse when I run, so I'm not going to keep doing that. So instead, what I like to do is stuff that's maybe a little bit more low impact, a little lower impact. You might pedal on a fan bike. You might pedal on a, you know, a real bike that moves through the road. You might go on an elliptical, you might go on a VersaClimber, a Jacob's Ladder, you might go on a spin bike, you might go on a recumbent bike, though those are kind of weird. I don't know if I buy into those. There's another one, the rower is another great example, the ski erg. Like, if anything that is repetitive and continuous can fit into this long, slow duration activity, and I can start to train my aerobic system by doing continuous activity. Try not to take breaks. When you're starting out, you need to take breaks at some point, especially if, you know, you're more and more untrained. But what you want to keep track of then is how many breaks you take until that number is zero. And then what you can do is you can start to track the time it takes for you to travel a certain distance. Or you can track how far you travel, how long you go in a given amount of time. I've found that for the time thing, if you have a set time, it's a little less motivating. You know, I'm okay with people walking uphill on the treadmill for 30 minutes or one episode of their favorite Netflix show. That's actually totally okay with me. As long as you can continue this movement, you're getting good aerobic benefits out of it. Long, slow duration activities, good for developing the aerobic energy system. If you're detrained, try to track how many breaks you need to take, get that number to zero, and then track your performance in a given time or your performance for a given distance. I think that is the TLDR. If you have any questions about LSD activities, feel free to leave a comment below. I'm sure there will be sarcastic comments down below. Maybe you could be the first.